Topic that we covered last time. Yes, second topic.
We talked about symbol sukoon.
Yes, very good. Mm-hmm. We also talked about symbol sukoon. You all remember it?
Yes.
Okay. And how does it work? Maybe some brother tell us about the function of symbol sukoon. No fatra,
no
harakat.
Just silent or just like
the... Yes, there is no haraka if the letter is silent. Yes. If there is no fatha, kasra, dhamma on any consonant, so by default, there will be a sukoon. Okay? This is the function of symbol sukoon. Very good. Third thing, third topic. Brother Ali.
We read about wow and ya, and not as long vowel, but the consonant.
As the consonant, very good. So these three long vowels, wow, alif, ya, they have two functions. Okay, earlier we learned all these three as long vowels, right? Last week we also learned two of them, wow and ya, as the consonant, and we are going to learn about alif as the consonant in next unit. Okay, so make it clear that out of all 28 Arabic letters, 25 of them are already consonants. Only 3 are long vowels, waw, alif, ya. But these 3 also, sometimes they function as the consonant. So does someone remember when they become consonant, waw and ya? In what conditions?
The beginning of the word.
If waw or ya comes in the beginning of the word, then it becomes a consonant. Any example? Any example of any word? Wasab. Wasab. And wajib. Yes, very good. So that was one condition when they come in the beginning of the word. And both of them, you give me the example of waw. What is the example of ya, any sister? From the example of ya?
Do you?
Okay. This is also example of ya, but not in the ya is not in the beginning of this word.
Yajib.
Yes. And
Yahud.
Okay. Okay. Yasub or Yatub. Yes. Very good. All these are the example of ya. The example that you gave, sister Jayub, it is also the second condition for waw and ya to become a consonant. And can someone remind that condition? Yes, when you have a short vowel or the long vowel before or after waw and ya, then this waw or ya becomes consonant. Is it clear? One more thing we learned in the same discussion, and that thing was diphthong. Diphthong, that sound is I sound or au sound, right? Au or I. So for diphthong, what is the condition, Brother Harun?
The diphthong, what's the condition?
When vau or ya becomes diphthong sound. The letter waw or ya itself has the sukoon and previous letter has the fatha. Then it becomes a diphthong. Give me the example. Thawb, yes. Bait.
Zawj.
Yes, zawj. Brother Harun liked the word zawj. Okay. Very good. So, inshallah, today we will talk about the vocabulary, the Arabic vocabulary. Since you know that the objective of our class are 4 skills, so we are working on writing Arabic, reading Arabic, whatever the test you just had, it was for writing, connecting the letters, dictation, and the information about the letters. So it will be helpful for reading and writing, but for speaking Arabic you need the vocabulary. Okay, so how we should work on Arabic vocabulary so that we should be able to speak Arabic, and also it will be helpful if we are writing some, you know, short essay, article in Arabic. So we need a vocabulary like every language. So what is the good, you know, tips, what is the good technique to make our vocabulary active? So remember two words about the vocabulary. One thing, you need an active vocabulary, and the second thing, you need to own the words. You become the owner of the word. Like you are the owner of your house, owner of your car, owner of your business. Same way you become owner of the words, then vocabulary will be easy. And what does these two terminologies mean, active and own? Active means that whenever you learn a new word, just do not learn for the sake of learning. You during the lesson we have the new words, and you are asking what is the meaning of this word, what is the meaning, and keep writing, but we are not using them. We are not producing a new sentence from that word. So active means that you are producing those words that you learned in your daily life. Relate those words with your daily life. Make a sentence out of that. This means active vocabulary. And owning also, you become owner of the word, it also means that you are using them. So this is very close the meaning of both active and owning of the words. And we have a very good, you know, discussion about that. I want you to read it so it will be more, inshallah, clear each and everything. And then you can make those points. It will suggest you how to bring in, you know, fluency in Arabic, how you become fluent in Arabic. So, Brother Rahil, inshallah, can you read the first line?
Is that 60?
Yes. Page number 60. Yes. Sitin in Arabic. Sitin.
Sitin.
Now.
Vocabulary and conversation reading people. In a few short weeks, you will have mastered the Arabic alphabet and sound system.
Learning. Okay, bas. Yeah, stop it here. This is the very important line, the first line. Mashallah, you have been working on the Arabic alphabets and sound system. In the very few short weeks, you are just looking for, inshallah. In a few weeks, you will be mastered in all the Arabic alphabet and the sound system. How to pronounce them, how to connect all those Arabic letters, right? So you will be mastered, inshallah. And so far, you can, you know, evaluate your own performance. From starting from Alif, now we have completed the letter Kha, right? So you know everything about all these letters. So it's the same way you will become master, inshallah, in other alphabets. But the second thing that we need to focus simultaneously at the same time is the vocabulary. So please continue.
Learning vocabulary, on the other hand, in a process that takes much longer. Mm-hmm. Ultimately, your fluency in Arabic will depend more than anything else on the range and accuracy of your vocabulary.
Okay, please stop here now. So our vocabulary depends on two things, and you can make a point, you can write it down. Point number one. Point number one for vocabulary. Our vocabulary depends on two things. Range of the words and accuracy. Range means that if today you know 20 words Arabic, 20 words in Arabic, by next week you should know 25, and every week you keep increasing, so your range of vocabulary should be always increasing. Okay, so it is very important to be fluent in Arabic. And the second thing, accuracy. Any new word that you learn, you should also learn how to pronounce it, how to say it properly. And for that, you need practice. So these two keywords, range and accuracy. Yes.
Can you
Next.
As the vocabulary list accumulates, you will need to develop good strategies for active vocabulary acquisition. By active, we mean that you have not really learned a word unless you can produce it as well as understand it in context.
Okay, please stop here. So I already told you about this, you know, active vocabulary, and you can write this point number 2. And yet the heading is active vocabulary, and then write the meaning of active vocabulary, that you produce the sentences using the same vocabulary. For example, last time we learned about the word bait. Bait means house. Now you are making sentences. My house is close from masjid. My house is on the street, such and such street. Right? So, my house is big, my house is small. So, whatever sentences you can produce, you make from the same word. This is active vocabulary. Yes.
The drills and exercises in this book that you do at home and in class are meant to help you in the process of activating vocabulary and how to show your various strategies and activities that may be useful for you to do on your own.
Okay. So, for activating the vocabulary, we need activities. Okay, this is called in Arabic nishat, nishatat, and nishatat to ta'limiya or ilmiya means activities. So, we have drills in the book. So, these drills are models for you, examples for you. It does not mean that you keep yourself restricted only in these drills. Drill is the model, and then you make your own drills. You make your own exercises. Yes.
Studying or reviewing vocabulary should be part of your daily life, and it does not need to be done at a desk.
Okay, very good. Yes. What do we think, that we have a chart of the words in the vocabulary and we put it somewhere in our bedroom or office or next to the computer, and we are just staring at those words, just reading, and should be on the desk? No. It does not mean. The new words, they should be here in your mind, and you are working on those words in your daily life. Yes.
We believe that most efficient strategies for learning vocabulary are those that combine mechanical and creative activities in multiple modes. Notice, for example, the staring and the at the vocabulary chart is much
staring.
Less, staring at the vocabulary chart is much less productive than reading, listening, and repeating the words aloud. Another good practice is to write the word 5 to 10 times in an Arabic script
as much as
you can, and to pronounce words simultaneously.
Yes. This another good technique is that all the new words that you learn, keep writing them in Arabic. Arabic script 5 times, 10 times. Just pick 5 words in one week or 7 words in 1 week, but write them down in Arabic several times until you own that word. This is the way you are getting the ownership. And if I give you those words in dictation, it should be a piece of cake for you to write it down. Yes. Next.
The creative part of the vocabulary work comes in the form of your own production, both speaking and writing. You will remember best the words that you own that have become part of your world. For every word you learn, think about what you can say with it that relates to your life. You talk with your classmates in class, at home you can talk to yourself, or the cat, the dog, or even the goldfish.
Okay, you know, sometimes make excuse for Arabic. They say that we do not have the environment for Arabic. How can we speak? With whom we should speak? And they give the example, you know, compare with Spanish. They say that if you are learning Spanish, you have the environment. You go outside, people are speaking Spanish. There are so many TV programs on Spanish, you know. In Spanish you are watching. But what is the BIA? That is called BIA in Arabic, environment. So, this is the good BIA that you talk among yourselves, the classmates, your those friends, those who are Arabic speakers, or even you can talk to your cat, or dog, or goldfish. Okay.
Next. write to a real or imaginary person, to your classmate or teacher, or just to yourself, the important thing is that you create with the words you are learning. It does not matter if what you say is not entirely correct. Accuracy will develop over time and you will learn to monitor and correct yourself.
Yeah, this is also a very key point. Some people, they always have hesitation. Oh, if I write, I will make mistakes. This hesitation should be completely removed. And I am that type of a person that I appreciate your mistakes. The more mistakes you will do, the more happy I will be. Because in this way, you will get a chance to monitor yourself, to correct yourself, inshallah. Okay? So do not worry about the mistakes, or it will not be correct, so how can it show it? No. Yes.
One final point to keep in mind is that you will not be able to express everything that you want to write now. Resist the temptation to ask for or look up extra new words, because this actually slows down your progression to fluency. It is important at this level to focus more on what you can say than what you want to say, and to try to say as much as you possibly can with words that you know now.
Yes. And this is the last point, but very, very much helpful and very important point. Right now you focus what you can say rather than what you want to say. What you want to say at this level is very hard, very difficult, because of the limited vocabulary. So do not worry about that. You cannot express whatever you want to say, but express that what you can say. If you know 50 words, 25 words, make the sentences only out of those 25 or 50 words. Okay? So this is very important. And we have some more new words on the vocabulary list on the next page. So read them quickly. And what I'm encouraging you, that this will be your homework, that make short sentences out of this vocabulary that you will learn today and the previous vocabulary words as well. So this is the third you know, chart or third list that you are learning today. Before that, we finished two exercises in the vocabulary. So page number 15, page number 41, 42, and this is today page number 61 and 62. These are all vocabulary words, put them together. And my advice is that you can copy these pages also. Copy all the pages of the vocabulary chart, put them together and then work out. Inshallah. So, now when you are reading the vocabulary words, there is another very good thing that they are trying for you to be able to read Arabic. The letters that you already learned from Alif to Kha, if any word will be in the vocabulary list, there will be no English transliteration provided for that. You have to read by yourself that word in Arabic. Okay, no English help. But those words that they have, you did not learn those letters or some of them, so then they keep providing you the transliteration. So I will ask every one person, every individual, to read one word in Arabic. Okay, we will start from Abiya. Read the first one, the easy one. Wa. So wa, it also has a meaning. That means and. Yes, second word.
Hijab.
Very good. So see, hijab is not written in English here.
Yes.
Because all the letters in hijab, ha, jim, alif, ba, you already learned. So everyone should be able to read in Arabic, hijab. Very good. Third one is bait. And bait is also ba, ya, ta. So we already learned all three letters. No English help. Yes.
On hijab, how would you pronounce the Shami version?
Okay. They do not pronounce the kasra in the beginning very clearly. Though they will start with the kasra, but that kasra is not very much, you know, visible. Or they do not pronounce it clearly. So
hijab will be?
It will be hijab, but not very quickly.
Hijab.
Yes. Okay. Fourth word?
Shari'.
Okay. Now in the word shari we did not learn about sheen yet, and ra and ayn. So that's why it is written in English. And you can see the symbol of C for the letter for the pronunciation of ayn. Shari. Shari means
street.
And you already use in the sentences.
Yeah. Shari, we already know that.
Yes. Okay, sister. And the brandy, next word. Wajib. Wajib. Because we have alif after vow, that is a long vowel, you need to stretch. Wajib. Yes, wajib means homework. One word wajib, from the Islamic terminology, we know everything that is obligatory. Right? But in daily life use, wajib also means that is homework, and homework is also wajib. Yes.
Shami version. It says wazif.
Wazife.
Wazife.
Yeah.
And then let me ask you this: that's in Arabic, in Urdu, we wazifa is like scholarship.
Yeah.
What does the word?
Right. Same word wazifa that we use in Urdu. This is also same spelling, same word. But the use of the word wazifa in Urdu is that scholarship, stipend, or any zikr that you do on regular basis every day, that is called wazifa. Okay? But this is also something that is, you know, you do it regularly. So this is the connection between the two meanings. But Syrian people, they say for homework wazife. Okay? This is, you know, regional dialect. And wajib is Fusha Arabic, and Egyptian, Misri, they also say wajib. Yes, one more sister there. Yeah, next word. Akhbar. Next word is akhbar. Akhbar means news. Now let me tell you the difference again between Urdu and Arabic. Arabic only news, not newspaper. In Urdu, we say akhbar, newspaper. But in Arabic, only news, not the newspaper. We have different word for newspaper in Arabic. That is jarida. Okay? Jarida. Newspaper in Arabic. So, I have found that some people, they use the word akhbar in the sentence the same way as they say in Urdu. For the newspaper, it will be wrong. Okay, now to the brother side, Harun.
Kitab.
Yes?
There's no word khabar in Arabic?
No. Khabar, this is Arabic word. But khabar means also news. What happens that when we have the news, they are many. Right? So that's why it is used as the plural. But the singular will be khabar. Yes.
Kitab.
Kitab. That means book. Everyone knows it. Yes. Brother Ali?
Habibi.
Now see in this word again, there is no English transliteration because you know Ha, Ba, Ya, Ba and Ya again.
Habibi.
So you have to read in Arabic, Habibi. Now, Habibi is more wider, you know, sense in Arabic. It is everyone, those, the loved one. Okay? So your parents, you also can say, to your parents also Habibi, because they are very loving to you. And the parents, the same way, they can use this word for their children, because children are loving to the parents. So it is not only for one meaning that is beloved, but for you can use it. This is most
dear.
Yeah, my dear. Yes,
my dear.
However, there will be difference for the male and for female. So Habibi, if you are saying for a male person. And the second word, Brother Omar?
Habibati.
Habibati, yes. Habibati, if you are saying to a female. Now the Fusha, you say Habibati, and in the colloquial they say Habibti.
Habibti.
Habibti. Okay? So this is the difference in the pronunciation.
Habibati.
Next.
Sabah
al khair. We already learned this word. Good morning. Right? Sabah means morning. Khair means good. Yes.
Sabah al noor.
Sabah al noor. That is the response of Sabah al khair. Yes. Next. Ya is very important in Arabic. Use of ya. Whenever we call someone, even I'm talking to you, and if I would like to address Brother Tanveer, for example, I will say Ya Tanveer. Ya Talib. Yeah.
So in Quran, many places, you know, like
Ya Ayyuhal Ladin Amun.
Ya Ayyuhal Ladin Amun.
Yes.
Is it the same meaning here?
Yes, same meaning. Same meaning.
You know,
yes.
God is addressing.
God is addressing sometimes only believing people,
okay,
and sometimes all the humanity when he says Ya Ayyuhan Nas. Or non-believers,
yes.
Ya Bani Israel, very good. Yes. Over there he is addressing the children of Israel. Yes. Okay, next. Kaifa. Kaifa means
how.
And we have the use in the sentence also, kaifal.
Kaifal hal.
Kaifal hal.
Kaifal
hal. Like you, when you ask someone, kaifal hal. So now you ask two ways, kaifal hal or kaifa haluk. For male, kaifa haluka. For female, kaifa haluki. Yes. Next.
Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah. So alhamdulillah can be as the answer of kaifal hal. Alhamdulillah. Yes. Next. Tamam.
Yeah, tamam.
Oh, you should read the next one, Jayid. 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 Yes. So, Jayid means also good. You can say as the response of Kaif al hal, you can say Ana Jayid. Or something that is nice, or some person you want to say that person is very nice person, you can say Huwa Jayid. Yes.
So, Imam Sahib.
You said Jarida is
newspaper. Yes.
Is that from like a Jadid?
No. It does not have any connection with Jadid. Jadid is with Dal, that is new. And this is Ra, Jarida. Yes, from Jarada.
Jarada means what?
For the newspaper, you know, something that is on the written on the paper, that is called Jarida. Yes. Next word. Okay, now for Jayid, this is Fusha Arabic, and for the colloquial, especially Syrian, they say Tamam.
Tamam.
So on Egyptian also Tamam.
Tamam.
So,
tamam.
Yes.
Tamam.
Kullu Tamam.
Kullu Tamam.
Yeah. Yes. Next one.
The next one, does it have should I read the okay one or this?
Yes, for okay, there's also colloquial use, they say Mashi.
Jayid.
Mashi. Mashi means also okay. No problem. Not. It's okay. Mashi.
So you can say Jayid for that too, right?
Jayid. Yes. You can say Jayid also for that. So Jayid will be formal Arabic. Mashi or Tamam, it will be colloquial. Yes. Next word.
Hada.
Hada means this. So you have two different pronunciations. Hada is formal. That is in the Quran as well. But in Syrian and Egyptian, Hada. Or Egyptian just sometimes say Da.
Da.
Without Ha. Like Dal Kitab, for example. This book.
Wow.
Yes. Next.
Hada
and Haida. Yes, Haida also, yes. And sometimes Syrian people, our brother Amjad is sitting, mashallah, over here, they remove Da in from the end. They just say Hai. Yes. Right? Next. Okay, Bikhair. No, you forgot the female. Hadi. Yes. Okay. You probably already know it, but in Arabic, we have every word, every noun, either human beings or non-humans, we have a gender for that. Okay? There is no word in Arabic non-gendered. So, if you are pointing to the qalam, you will say hada or book hada. But if you are pointing to the car, for example, sayyara, this car, so sayyara is the feminine word in Arabic, then you will say hadihi. Yes, this is the use.
So, we cannot say hada sayyara.
No, you cannot say hada sayyara. Yes, hadi. Okay, next. Next.
Bikhair.
Bikhair. Now, there are so many words for the response of kaifal hal. So one is also you can say bikhair, ana bikhair, alhamdulillah ana bikhair. Yes, okay. For bikhair we have two more colloquial words. Yes. Manih. Maniha. This is Syrian, you know, dialect. And again, our brother Amjad will say it. Say it. Actually, the first letter meem is silent, though it's written, but when you say it, you will say neeh. Neeh. So meem will be slightly, very slight. Neeh. And if you are saying ana mani, then you say anam neeh. Anam neeh. Yes. Ha ha, yes. Neeh. Ha ha, yes. And for female, say anam neeha. Okay. However, this Egyptian dialect, kuwais. So male, say ana kuwais. And female, kuwaisa. Next word? Laisa. Laisa, yes. You need to pronounce fatha in the end, laisa. And laisa means no. It's for the negation. Like you're going to say, I'm not well, I'm not okay, right? Then you will say, ana laisa bikhair.
Okay?
Now, laisa has a conjugation. So, you can say laisa for hua, he is not well. Then you say, hua laisa bikhair. But for you, ana, I will say lastu. Ana lastu bikhair. We will talk later, we will learn this conjugation, you know, the verbs they have for he will be different, she will be different, ana will be different. So, if you remember the response of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the very first time Jibreel alayhi salam came to him in the cave of Hira, with the very first revelation, Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq, and he said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Iqra. So, what was the response of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He used the word lastu. He said, ana lastu biqari'in. Yes? Ana lastu biqari'in.
I'm not the one of the readers.
I'm not the one who is going to read. So then Jibreel salam three times asked him, and then he said third time, he hugged him and squeezed his body also. And then he released him and said, Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. So when he said Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq, read in the name of your Lord, then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam started reading it. So
laisa is the same thing as laisal birra.
Ha, laisal birra, very good, that you have in the Quran. Laisal birra, Allah said the bir, the piety is not antuwallu wujuhakum, that you face, you turn your face qibal al mashriq wal maghrib, towards the east or towards the west. This is not the piety. وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ. But the real piety is that those who believe in Allah, those who believe in the Day of Judgment, those who believe in the angels and the books and all that, this is it. So, laisa, very good, is the same meaning in the Quran. However, laisa is for Fusha Arabic, for colloquial, we in Syrian we say mu. So, if you say, I'm not well, how do you say in Syrian? Mani and mu.
Mumniha.
But you will not say mumni.
Yeah, I'm just a mumni.
Yeah. Yes. For male, mumni. Ana mumni. For female, ana mumniha. Okay?
Mish twice?
Okay. Now, Egyptians, they say mish. So, the kuwais is Egyptian. Right? And I'm not doing well. Ana mishkwayis. And mishkwayis. These are. No, this is the variety of, you know, Arabic, richness of Arabic. That kwayis is also Arabic word, but they are using it for that meaning of I'm doing okay.
So, also heard some Arabic brothers, especially from Somalia, who speak Arabic. They say quays, not quays. So, is that quays is the same thing? Or
same thing. They do not pronounce shadda.
Okay.
And you will find this in spoken Arabic, most of the time they do not pronounce shadda. Those words, they have the shadda, in reality, but when you pronounce them, you pronounce quickly without the shadda. Yes. Okay. So now you see that they have explained again here for the word Habibi and Habibati, that this is for everyone, can be used with anyone you love, including children, parents, and close friends. Okay.
One more question.
Yes.
Is Habiba the same thing as Habibati?
Okay, Habiba is same as Habib. Without this possession, my, you say the word Habib. Habib means darling or loving one. So for female, you say Habib. For female, will be Habiba. Okay, but in that word, you do not have the meaning of my. So the difference between Habibi and Habib. Habib is friend, Habibi my friend. Same thing, Habiba for female or Habibati my
love. Last, the final A brings the my, right?
Yes.
Possessive, that's a possessive.
That's a possessive pronoun. Okay, so we are stopping here, and what I will do, I will leave after Asr prayer, but I already put the CD here, the Egyptian dialect that we practice our very first time, and our brother Amjad inshallah will go with you for this spoken Arabic practice. So for some 15-20 minutes inshallah you can make some practice, and then next week you will bring sentences, right?
Sure.
Active vocabulary, and you are the owner of the words inshallah.
Sure.
And there is a drill number 13. It will help you to make the sentences. Read this drill number 13, inshallah. Now, any brother, Adhan, inshallah.